Student of Standard 9, welcome to you, and today we are going to start a new chapter, that is chapter number 1, Rise of the British Rule in India. So friends, you know it very well, we had heard this thing ki hamara desh sone ki chidiya hua karta tha. So things were not exactly right now. Right now we can see that USA is a superpower country and India is not. But earlier the things were totally different. India was a superpower. Right now, remember, it's a USA. So let's begin. So nowadays it's a trend that we used to visit foreign countries, European countries, American, and we think that they are very rich country and all that. But earlier things were quite opposite. People come to our country, they learn our language, our Indian things like spices, muslin, silk cloth, indigo, they are totally in demand in the European market. And why they are demand in European market? Because European country are very cold places, and to make them warm, they get to use Indian spices. So friends, they're coming through the land route. Let me show you in this map. See, in the map you can see on the left side of the Africa, top part of the Africa, there is a sea part is written on it, and then Turkey, Iraq, Baghdad, Iran, and from Arab country, they all used to come to our country. So this is how they're trading, and meanwhile they're using this route. And friends, in the year, now remember, in the year 1453, the place I had shown the sea in the map, it was captured by the Turkish Muslim people, and it's a place nowadays we can say Istanbul. So it was close, so they blocked the route, so people from the Europe, they can't come to India, and people from India, they can't go to the European country. So land route is completely blocked. Now European people can't do without spices, so a new era has begun to discover a sea route. If they can't go through the land, then sea route is another way. So the first thing, I'm again going to show you this map. See, the African map, and from the Atlantic Ocean there is a route, Portugal, which is the capital of Lisbon, come to the bottom of part of the Africa, there is Cape of Good Hope is shown. So Bartholomew Dias is the person who discovered this Cape of Good Hope. And again, Spanish king, he also encouraged some sailor. And friends, Christopher Columbus is the person who decided to search for the sea route. So presently he started his journey, and ultimately he reached. Where he reached? There is a place called West Indies, between North America and South America, and Bahamas Islands we can say. And he think that he discovered a new sea route to India, but actually he didn't. He discovered something new, and that mistake was rectified by the Amerigo Vespucci, an Italian sailor. So on his name, the continent get his name like North America and South America. So friends, they are going for searching India, but they search something new. Now the question arises in your mind that who discovered? Well, the answer is Vasco da Gama. Remember friend, Columbus discovered America in 1492. So you can see bottom of the map, sea route to India. So again, how did Columbus discover? Again, he have the same route of the Bartholomew Dias, and he reached the Cape of Good Hope. With the help of one Indian sailor, ultimately he discovered the Indian sea route, and the first place he reached is the Calicut. And there is a king in India, there is a king, Jamorin, who give permission to this Portuguese people to trade with India. Now Portuguese, they come to your country, they purchase all the spices and they sell to the European countries, and remember they get good margin also. Okay, so after the Portuguese were successfully doing trading business with the India, and meanwhile they established their trading center at Diu, Daman, Goa, Cochin, Malacca and all such places. After them, Dutch people came to in India, people from Holland or Netherlands we can say, people from Denmark, they also coming to India for trading purpose. And after them, the Britishers came to in India. Remember friends, their Queen Elizabeth gave permission to some of the traders to trade with India. So in the year 1600, the first ship came to in India, and it is landed on the Surat. And Captain William Hawking is the first person. But due to the Portuguese people, they don't like these Britishers to trade with India, and they haven't got any permission from the Mughal king. So not useless. Okay, they not get permission. But after when the Mughal emperor changed, they got the permission very easily. And the Britishers meanwhile, first of all, they trading with our country, but due to the Marathas, they felt some kind of danger, and they focus on the eastern coast of India, and they established their trading center. Well, Machilipatnam, where is my photo here? Okay, Machilipatnam, of course in Andhra Pradesh, St. George, Chennai we can say, William Port, Kolkata, and Mumbai was their headquarters in the year 1687. After them, French East India Company was also established, and French people were also established their trading center in the Mahe, Karaikal, Pondicherry, Chandranagar, Machilipatnam and all that. So you can see Portuguese came, Danish came, people from Holland came, Britishers came, and number five and the last, French also came. So friends, there are five people from the European side who trading with India, and there is a frequent conflict between the French people and the British people. Okay, and there are some wars is also happened. Four wars have happened. So ultimately, the Dutch people and the Danish people they left the India. Now, for trading purpose, there is only three countries exist. You can see in this map below the Bay of Bengal. You can see Diu, Daman and Goa is the only colonies left for the Portuguese people. And French people, they also rule in India. They also trading with India with limited trading center with a triangle, and the blue one indicate for the Britishers. Now friends, we know it very well that Britishers laid their foundation in our country through the Battle of Plassey that we are now going to discuss. Sirajuddin, ruling over Bengal, he is an impulsive nature. Impulsive nature means what? It is some kind of strict nature. Friends, remember, people don't like the strict people, and the Britishers were not paying their taxes regularly, and on top of it, they are making fort, kilebandi jisko bolte, making all around the, with, and that is without the permission of Sirajuddin. So he got angry and he destroyed all the ports. People again, they ran from the Kolkata and they go to the Chennai. Now a small army with a Robert Clive, they come to Kolkata and they try to convince the Sirajuddin, but Robert Clive knew that Sirajuddin is not going to accept them. So they decided to attack on Sirajuddin, but Robert Clive knew this thing, that if he attack directly on the then things is not going to work. So what they do, they made a plan, and they made their commander in chief, that is Mir Jafar, on their side, and they made a conspiracy, they made a plan, and according to the plan, the Sirajuddin's army is going to be defeated, and it is defeated. Well, in the yellow box it is given that the Battle of Plassey was fought on 23rd June 1757, and it is a place situated in West Bengal, from 38 km away from the Murshidabad. Murshidabad is one of the capital, and things were going to the plan, and the Britishers won. Now Britishers were, now they made another Nawab, Mir Jafar, and they took control over the 24 pragnas. 24 pragnas is one of the district in our country, and it is in West Bengal. Now Battle of Buxar. Friends, you can see in the Battle of Plassey that Mir Jafar is a Nawab. So Mir Jafar is kind of like a puppet. वो कठपुतली का शो होता है ना, ऊपर से कोई और ऑपरेट करता है, नीचे वो गुड्डा गुड़िया डांस कर रहे होते हैं, समथिंग लाइक दैट. सो सेम थिंग, सो मिर जाफर इज अ पपेट एंड ब्रिटिशर्स वेयर कमांडिंग देम. सो मीन वाइल वेन द ब्रिटिशर्स फील दैट मिर जाफर कैन बी डेंजर फॉर देम, सो दे अपॉइंट मिर काजिम एज अ न्यू नवाब. बट मिर काजिम इज अगेन वेरी क्लेवर रूलर, एंड again Britishers felt danger from him also, so they made again Mir Jafar as the Nawab of the Bengal. So friend, Mir Kazim go and convince some of the Indian kings like Nawab of Awadh, okay, and Mughal Emperor Shah Alam, and they all three unite their army, and they decided to launch an attack on the Britishers, because it is very important to defeat the Britishers. So Battle of Buxar took place. So when Battle of Buxar happens, friend, remember Battle of Plassey 1757, but Battle of Buxar plus 7, so 1764, and you know what happened, the United Army lost and the Britishers won. Now a major part of the Indian subcontinent goes with the Britishers. Now think, Britishers now not able to, they have not able to, they will not able to pay any taxes on, they are in such condition, they can collect taxes from our farmer also. Friends, when I say Britishers, you have to remember East India Company only. So East India Company is the company who is ruling to our country, okay. So I think I changed the camera setting. Now expansion of the company rule. So friends, as you know that let's back, double tap means change the camera. Now expansion of the company rule. Once the company had established their rule over the region of Bengal, so they decided that if they conquer some of the Indian territories, then they not need to pay any taxes. So their main hurdle is the Mysore. Of course, Mysore is the kingdom, right? Today we can, if we search, then it is somewhere near Karnataka, okay? And in the Karnataka area, they were supporting the French people. So they don't like the two things. They don't like the French people also, and they don't like the Mysore also. So there are four wars fought between the Mysore and the Britishers, and they take help from the Marathas also. So four war happened. First two wars, first Mysore war, second Mysore war is happened with the Hyder Ali. Hyder Ali is the father of Tipu Sultan, and third and fourth war, Tipu Sultan. In the fourth war we are going to see Tipu Sultan is going to be lost. Now when Britishers took control in India, to see all such things, they appointed a Governor General. You can see Governor General William Bentinck, okay. And after Governor General, British Governor General Warren Hastings, Cornwallis become the next Governor General, I can say, and who defeated the Tipu Sultan. Okay, so after Cornwallis, Sir John Saul become the Governor General, and meanwhile they took control over the Mysore area. So at that time they felt that Marathas were very dominant at that time. So what Britishers do? They made such a plan that Marathas kings were fight internally and they become weak. And they when they become weak, then they took easily easily control the Marathas king. And friends, they were successful in their plan. By the year 1818, they also defeated the Marathas also. So the whole half of the India below the topic of cancer, Britishers were successfully captured. And this thing made more possible due to their Governor General Wellesley. Wellesley made a plan. They attract all the Indian kings with their I can say a good scheme, subsidiary alliance system, and all the kings of India get trapped. Now who were the kings? Well, the Nizam of Hyderabad, Mysore is also already defeated. So Awadh, Gaikwad, Sindhia, Bhosle and Holkar, all such kings were trapped due to the Lord General Wellesley. Now there are some terms and conditions that they have to put some British army in their state. When some king attack, then they can rescue him. And all the expenses related to that British army is going to be paid by the king only. And they can't sign any treaty, and they can't go into any wage any war with any king without the permission of the Britishers. There is one English officer also appointed to each kingdom who accept their subsidiary alliance system. And then friends, their strategy is to control over the situation. And the last condition, that the king were not going to employed any foreigner means they want to took control over the French people only. So you can see in this picture the Britishers trapped all the Indian kings, and it's working like a sweet poison. The king thinks that Britishers is going to help us when any king attack, so they become lazy, and ultimately Britishers got benefit of it. And after that, they decided, Britishers were planning to attack on Nepal. They made Gurkhas on their side. They attack on Pindaras, and the Marathas also were defeated. So things all were going to the Britishers' favor. Now somewhere after 1818, the new Governor General William Bentinck appointed. And William Bentinck knew that in India people are don't like Britishers, so he decided to win the Indian heart. So he participate in our cultural programs and trying to understand our problem and try to sort out some of our problems. So so he did many things, remove the sati system, piti, that we already discussed in standard 8. Now after him, Dalhousie become the next Governor General, and you can see in the chart, I'm going to through the left to right, annexation of war. So friends, they defeated Punjab and Pegu is the lower Brahma part, and they made a plan. Now the kingdom who are not having any legal hire means what? Means king having no son. So by this plan they can able to conquer Satara, Jaitpur, Sambalpur, Udaipur, Jhansi, Bhagat and Nagpur. Udaipur, not the Rajasthan one, it's a one. Udaipur is in MP at exist at that time. Now exist, who knows. Now mismanagement was exist in the Awadh, so Britishers took control over there on the name of. And Nizam province, of course, and they get a lot of debt to the Nizam, and Nizam has to follow them. Nowadays China giving a lot of debt to Pakistan, so Pakistan, danger sign for you. Now and annexation for the namesake means king who is someone else but control of the Britishers. Now friends, Britishers started many things in our country. They started first railway in our country between Mumbai to Thane in the year 1853. They started wireless system, that means they can they get connected to the England very easily, and they advocate the widow remarriage, they passed law regarding the child marriage and all that. So friends, remember, from Battle of Plassey happened in 1757, and Battle of Buxar, after Battle of Buxar they took control in India, they defeated Mysore, they took control over the Nizam, and they took control over the Marathas also, and within a 100 years they took control over the major portion of the Indian subcontinent. Okay, the only biggest hurdle for the Britishers is Maharaja Ranjit Singh of Punjab. Meanwhile, when Maharaja Ranjit Singh goes alive, Britishers were not thinking for the to enter in the Punjab, but the Maharaja, after the death of the Maharaja Ranjit Singh, the Britishers were successful in took control in all the part. Now friends, we are going to see some last two topic, that is economic impact of the company. During the 100 rule, what the Britishers do, they took all our raw material and they process in the England factory, and the goods goods were prepared, then they sell in the Indian market in a high price. Friends, remember, they purchase raw material at a very lower price. So what they exported to their country, cotton, cloth, raw silk, sugar, jute and muslin, and people were become very poor and poor at a time. So they have to face dual power policy, Dumukhi Shasan we can say, where kings were there, Indian king, but they don't have any power, and Britishers, they have full power, they can take our money, but they are not ready to accept any responsibility for of the country. So people become very poor. Our village, which were self-reliant, were completely demolished. So India is just a country for the Britishers to provide them raw material, and our artisan, our weaver, all were get poor. People goes in the debt. They lost their land also. The land which they have owned, now they are become labor on their own land, and things were going in the favor of the Britishers only. Now social impact, we can see that all thing not goes in the against the Indian, but there are something there are certain things which are going in the India's favor also. Newspaper had started in our country, social evil custom like child marriages, female infanticide, sati system were abolished, and meanwhile Rajaram Mohan Roy also contribute in it. English education is also started, train is also started, and many things have started. So friend, now we are going to conclude the chapter that Britishers come to India by seeing the prosperity, but due to the laziness of our king, we lost against them, and finally they become the powerful in our country. So friends, what are the learnings of this chapter? That if we are a king, then we have to be powerful king, otherwise some Britishers came and they took control over it. Thank you very much. Here our chapter is completed. So in our next session we are going to discuss the question answer of it. Thank you so much.